In the 2016 and 2020 elections, former President Trump powered through the traditionally purple state of Iowa en route to solid victories, largely thanks to the help of Christian voters, the beating heart of the heartland. One of those voters, Bonnie Reinders of Sioux Center.
I was very impressed with his ability to say clearly what he planned to do and then execute it.
Reinders saw a candidate who stood up for her Christian values, especially the issue of abortion. On the other hand, lifelong Republican Sandy Orth of Des Moines felt the way he carried himself in office contradicted her Christian values. So, she voted for now President Biden, despite liking some of the former president's policies.
In my mind, it didn't overcome his demeanor and his character.
The Pew Research Center found over 80% of white evangelical voters broke for Trump in 2020. A demographic with large populations in other key swing states, such as Wisconsin, Michigan, and Georgia, meaning Christian voters nationwide will help shape the future of the GOP.
A lot of them were very excited about President Trump's leadership. On the other hand, there was some real consternation with some of the persona, some of the rhetoric.
Orth fears the GOP is heading in the wrong direction.
I feel the Republican Party has left me. I hope the Republican Party gets a heart.
Reinders would like less political noise, too, but above all, wants a leader who relentlessly fights for her values.
Someone who is absolutely willing to speak the truth regardless of cost.
So the party is trying to keep some of these issues top of mind, and as it so happens, a number of potential 2024 GOP candidates, Kristi Noem, Mike Pence, Mike Pompeo, here in Iowa this Friday for the Family Leadership Summit. The focus? Christian conservatism. Des Moines, Iowa, Robert Sherman, Fox News.